to the class. Today we are going to learn about the major achievements of Egyptians in the field of astronomy. So what is an astronomy? Astronomy is a study of a universe beyond the earth atmosphere. So that is the definition of astronomy. So let's move. There is first point that we have to keep in mind when we are learning about astronomy, that is the Egyptians, they studied the movements of heavenly bodies to predict natural phenomena. So the Egyptians were studied about the movements of heavenly bodies, the movement of heavenly bodies to predict natural phenomena. To predict natural phenomena means predict means to tell something that is going to happen in a future, but that is not happen, but that will happen in a future. So that is known as a prediction. So predict a natural phenomena. So phenomena means the event. So they were able to predict, or they were able to foretell, or they were able to predict what is going to happen in the future. That is naturally what is there going to happen in the future. So that is a predict natural phenomena. They were able to predict natural phenomena. So second one, that is they counted years by observing the star Sirius, whose appearance coincided with the beginning of the animal flood in the river Nile. So next was they counted year by observing, by looking at the star. Name is Sirius. So they were looking at the star, and according to the appearance of the star, that is a coincide means to happen something at the same time, two things happen at the same time. Here the two things, that is the appearance of the star Sirius at the same time, what happened? It is the beginning or starting of the animal flood in a river Nile. So two incidents that is happening, that is one is the appearance of the star Sirius, and another was the animal flood in the river Nile. So two things happened. Then next is that they divided the sky into 12 constellations. So they divided the sky into 12 constellations. So they divided into 12, that is the sky. And the first to devise the zodiac. So devise means to find or to plan something. So they were able to plan about the zodiacs. They were the first to devise a solar calendar. So they were able to, or the Egyptians planned or to use the intellectual ability of one, or that is to plan. So they plan about a solar calendar. The next is and the average time between two floods in the river Nile was 365 days. So how they found an average that between two flood, from if a flood is happening this today, and next year at this time the flood is happen or going to happen. So those two floods, time between these two floods, they calculated as what? About 365 days in between two floods. The time between two floods they calculated as 365 days. The next is a star cigarettes appear on the horizon when flood reached Cairo. That happen after every 365 days. So that is a star cigarettes. As already we discussed here, there is a star cigarettes when it appeared on the horizon. Horizon is the skyline. To the skyline, the a line between or a separate between earth and sky. So that is a horizon. So when the star appears on a horizon, the flood reached where? Cairo. Cairo is the capital of Egypt. So that is when the star appears in the sky or in a horizon, what the flood reached in the capital of Cairo. That is a it happens every 365 days. The next is to lead. So it has led to the conclusion. So all these observations led to the conclusion of a year has a 365 days. So this was their conclusion, that a year is consisting of 365 days. And a year is they divided a year into 12 months, and each month is having 30 days, and they also added 5 days for celebrating festivals. In order to celebrate festival, so they added 5 more days. So this is clear. So I hope you understand this particular topic, that is the major achievements of Egyptians in the field of astronomy. So this is for today. Bye bye.